I move past for the closure. I'm older and I'm moving faster than ever. I'm cold with it, weather for caster. So whether it's four lines or more, I'm the master of never.
Alright guys, it's Pastor Jordan. We're here. Today I'm reacting to some more X. We have XXX TENTACION, Save Me. This is just a lyric video, but I'm excited. I just did an X song, and I literally, as I continue to listen to him, he's really growing on me too. His deeper meanings are growing on me, and as I understand him more from your comments and things that you say, I'm really enjoying the music more as I understand more of what it means. But that said, if you make music, remember my live stream this weekend, I'm reacting to your music. On my second channel, it's still always going to be free, but on this channel, if you want to take it to the next level, it's going to be like 15 to 10 bucks. Other than that, man, we're going to get started. So here we go. Here is X on Save Me. As far as the sound, this is probably my favorite one so far. I don't know, it's just like really, really pleasing to my ears. But he's basically saying he doesn't really have anybody to talk to. Like, he's just the only person he can talk to, the only person he can really open up to is his understanding of the reality of death. So he understands that death is a reality and that it's there, heaven and hell, dark and light. Like, these things are real in his life. And that's really his only friend, meaning that's all he can think about. That's all he can really focus on. That's all that's here right now. It's really eating him up. And he says, because of all this pain that I'm in, like, I feel like I'm alone. And if he's on a side, he's saying hello from the dark side. So, like, it's really about him being eaten up by the reality of death. And, you know, where are you going to go? What's going to happen? He talked about that in Train Food, too. Like, you really have to think about what you're doing with your life. You really have to think about the choices that you're going to make, because it doesn't affect you just for this life. It affects you for eternity. What you do with Jesus affects you for eternity. What you do with your life affects you for eternity. Those things have, like, really deep impacts, and it matters. And I want to say one thing. You don't have to be good to get to heaven. What you have to do is accept Jesus as your Savior. Meaning, it doesn't matter how good you are, that's not what gets you to heaven, because the bad is still always going to outweigh the good. One bad thing outweighs millions of good things. But that's a good thing for us, because we would all fail. Jesus died for that reason. So if you're really concerned with where you go and where you spend eternity, don't worry about being a better person. Worry about having a relationship with Jesus, and you'll get closer to him.
From the dark side in, does anybody here wanna be my friend? Want it all to end. Tell me when the fuck is it all gonna end?
For real. He says, does anybody here wanna be my friend?
Anybody here wanna be my friend? Want it all to end. Tell me when the fuck is it all gonna end? What's this in my head?
And like I said, he really is just really concerned with death and the reality of death and the eternal place for his soul. He's saying there's all these voices in his head telling him that he's going to die, telling him that, you know, it's... And the fact that he did die, like, so quick, is really crazy. Really, really crazy. I think there's some truth to everything he was feeling and struggling with. This guy was into a lot of spiritual stuff, and I don't always think that that's a very safe thing to be doing. Some of you guys have asked me, like, what I think about spirituality and, like the stars and tarot cards and, like, Ouija boards and everything else. I think all of that is a really bad idea. And I think it really messes with you. I think it can really affect you in a lot of negative ways.
Voices in my head telling me I'm gonna end up dead.
Could you imagine being the person that is recording this with him and hearing this and mixing it and editing it, and then you find out that he dies? Or, like, for some of you that were really with X before he died, like, really, really listening to him, really, like rocking with him hard, like, hearing these songs and the fact that he died, like, it has to hit you so hard, because I don't know, I've told you guys, like, the stuff you mess with, the way that you live your life, like, for Juice, it's not hard to believe that he died just because of the life he was living. And so he talked about dying all the time. I don't think it was hard for him to believe that he died. And some of you think, like, oh my gosh, it's a big conspiracy. He knew he was going to die. No, he knew he was going to die because of the life he was leading. He knew where he was headed. I feel like this is really similar. But also not at the same time, because he felt like he was going to die and he was afraid of death. And he was really struggling with the reality of death. But then also, he didn't die from, like, an overdose. He wasn't leading his life in a way that he was going to die, unless it was more secret than what's on these songs, because he was murdered. It wasn't like he OD'd. He was just murdered. And so to me, it's really crazy that he felt so confident that he was going to die young and die soon, and it just had happened in such a, like, a weird, tragic, but also, like, unpredictable way.
So save me before I fall. So save me. I don't wanna put all on.
That's crazy, bro. This is probably, as far as the sound, my favorite song so far. It sounds just really nice and pleasing and good. But it is, like, it's just really heavy, it's really deep, and it's really kind of creepy and eerie that he would write a song like that and be so confident that he was going to die, and then he died the way that he did. Like, with Juice, it's a little more understandable because he was really living a life that would lead that way anyways. But, for X, it's a little bit crazier. I think that's why you guys are so infatuated with his death. But if there's anything for you to be infatuated about death, let it be this. We are all going to die one day. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter how rich you are. Like, no money, no social status, nothing. Nothing changes the fact that you're going to die one day. You can't buy yourself out of it. You can't avoid it. You can't earn your way out of it. Everybody dies. It doesn't matter who you are, how powerful you are. You die. But what you do with your relationship with God and your relationship with Jesus matters. The way that you live your life matters. Not on terms of salvation, but in other ways. They have eternal effects. So be thinking about your death. What do you want your life to say? What do you want to leave behind when you're gone? And where do you want to go when you're gone? Because if you don't want to be in hell, look into Jesus. Look into it. Think about it. If you don't have to believe me, you don't have to agree with me, but if there's a chance, even a chance, and you just decided not to take it, not to look into it, not to invest into it, are you really being smart with your life? Right? if there was a chance that I was wrong, or if there was a chance that there was a different way, or if there was a chance that there was something else, I would look into it. Not because I could be so easily swayed, but because it's your soul, it's your eternal life. Don't be stupid. Don't be dumb with it. Take care of it. Look into it. Let death be a reminder that death is coming for you, and that you should really think about how you live your life and how you spend it. I really like the song. I really like the way it sounds. I really like continuing to dive deeper into X and who he was and what he was about, and having the opportunity to speak into you guys and to tell you things that I think. If you want more of that, make sure you hit the bell, because you guys keep asking for songs that I already did. You just don't see them. You gotta hit the bell, man, or you're not gonna see them. If you want to be in charge of what I react to next, go join my Patreon. Sometimes these songs get blocked, and so I have to cut out the music. So if you want to see the whole video, go join my Patreon, where I'm going to start posting them there. If you want to talk to me, go join my Discord. If you want to see me do fun stuff, hang out, play games, go join my second channel. And I will see you guys in the next video.
Yeah, I'm home for the night. I had a bad day. 11 years, I dealt with that the same way. Emotions spiraling, a pilot screaming, mayday, mayday. Porn screaming, make way. Make room in your life, I'll be your Potiphar's wife. I'll ease your pain and your strife. I'll be your reason to lie, so you can eat with your eyes. Make love with me in your mind. I've been looking for you, I just wanted to help you. I know you're struggling right now, it's been a while since I felt you. I know just a thing to ease the strain, that it overwhelm you. Just forget about your problems with the way that I touch you. I know you think about it, you open pictures.